Do you find sorting your core data stack to be really, really hard? Well, not anymore, because in this tutorial, we are going to learn all about sorting and fetching in core data. Now, I want you to hit that subscribe button and maybe hit that like button if you really did enjoy this video, because we are going to have a step-by-step example on core data fetching and sorting. Alex here from Rebeloper. Open up Xcode and let's dive in. Okay, so let's just see what we are going to build out today, and go ahead and take a look at the description where you can find all the links for the resources and the GitHub repository. So this is what we are going to build. It's called cats, and we are going to filter and sort all the cats. So if you just type to add some new cats here, they will be generated randomly. That's why we kind of got Oliver and age one kind of the same, and the happiness factor. And whether if they are hungry, that's also kind of a property. Let's just add a new one so you can see that we indeed get a new cat here. So what we are going to learn today is this new filter and sort, and we are going to filter and of course sort all of these cats. So that is what we are going to do. And let's just take a look at the Xcode project so we can better understand where we are at. I'm using Spark UI 0.11.11 just to make this view controller build out, the UI build out really, really fast. Go ahead, you can just use whatever you'd like, just so you know if you are taking a look at the code on a GitHub. So that's that. Anyway, we only care about the core data stuff. So if you take a look at the downloads, the resources, I will have to tell you one important thing here is that the core data stack fetch. Now, if you don't know about core data stack, go ahead and check out the link in the description for the whole playlist on this core data tutorial series, where you will understand what core data stack is. So right now, all I have to kind of explain as an extra is this fetch request of type async with a completion handler. So that is what we are going to use in some parts of our tutorial today. So what is this async? Well, basically when we are fetching a request from core data, that is handled it might take a few seconds. And if you are doing this on, of course, on the main thread, that will freeze the main thread. So what they suggest is that we use NS asynchronous fetch request. So basically that's what we should do always. So I set this to be as default as true. Now, we don't want to use the fetch, so fetch request on the manage context. We want to use execute. And basically those are kind of the differences between those two approaches. So that's the fetch. And let me just take a look. Yes, let's just take a look at the core data model. Okay, so first of all, we have our entity, that's a cat, age, cuteness level, image name, is hungry, and name. So these are kind of the attributes that we want to add in order for this tutorial to kind of explain all about fetch requests. Now, as you can see, we have here a lot of fetch requests already created. Now, these are default fetch requests. We will cover them in just a second. So we have a cat cell, and in the view controller, we just have a simple UI collection view. Now, I won't go detailing all of the UI stuff. What I do want to show you is that, let's just scroll all the way up and let's just start off by saying that here we have our cats array, and that will be populating the UI collection view controller. Now, here we have the add bar button item and the add cat. Go ahead and take a look at it. I have discussed this in a previous episode, how to add new elements into our core data. So new objects, basically. Filter and sort, bar bottom item. Now here comes the important part for our tutorial. And what I'm doing here is creating an alert, which is basically a UI alert controller in Spark UI. Go ahead and just use a simple UI alert controller, because as you can see here, we have a lot of UI alert actions. And basically what they are doing is referring to another function. Those are down here, but I will just go ahead and guide you through them at the appropriate time. Here we have our flow layout collection view. You don't have to worry about this. Set the left bar bottom and right bar bottom item, setting the collection view on the view. And here we have our data source for our collection view. As you can see, it's just using the cat array and the cat cell. Okay, now here we have our add cat. What you have to know is that we are generating a random cat. Basically, that's it. And we are saving it, saving the context. After that, we have a fetch cats. Now, that's just general. I have talked about this in previous episodes. This is just fetching an entity name of type cat. And this is also in the core data stack struct that I have created. And you can take a look at it. It's just simply fetching that type of entity. Okay, and this handle result is basically just, let's just scroll all the way down. It's just setting the collection view. So we are reloading on the main thread and we are setting the cats as the result. Otherwise, we just show an alert. Now, let's just move a little bit upward. And yeah, this fetch cats is just called upon viewDidLoad. In our case, it's an inscription of S view controller, and it's called on the onload, but basically on view did load. Okay, now here we have the fetch request with template, and let's start off with that. And after that, fetch ordered cutest cats and cutest age cats, and basically those are those. But let's just start off with fetch request with template. Now, what we are doing here is let me just jump to this definition on the struct there. We are basically creating a fetch request with that request name. Now, as you can see, this is persistent store coordinator, manage object model, fetch request template. And we need this request name. Now, what is this request name? Well, this is the easiest way to fetch or create fetch requests. And that is right over here, as you already saw earlier. Let's just take a look at the fetch request all. Now, we have created a fetch all cats, and we didn't do anything here. Now, request cute one, because, yeah, cuteness of one. Now, cuteness level, and as you can see, we can grab any of the entities here, and we can add in here a value, contains, is not, begins with, ends with, and so on. So this is cute one, cute two, and cute three, as you might have expected. Now, we also have fetch request hungry, and that is hungry is one, old, age is greater than or equal to three. Now, again, this depends on what type of fetch request you want. These are just pretty examples that you might want to consider taking a look. And the fetch request young is age is less than three. So those are my predefined fetch requests on the core data model. Now, how do you create one? You just long press on this button, add entity, and just long press. And then you can just simply scroll down. I don't know, you can't really see this, but you can just scroll down or up, whatever. I believe, yeah, you just need to scroll there to add fetch request. So add a fetch request, that is what you want. And then you can, with that name, now the important part, that with that name, you have to call that name exactly. And then you can just use that fetch request to your liking with the template. Now, let's just go ahead and go here. So here is our persistent store coordinator, manage object model, fetch request template. Now, go ahead and use this public function to your liking, because it's much more easy to call that. Let me just go all the way up. There we go. Let's just take a look. Yeah, there we go. Fetch request with template and fetch request hungry. So that's just that. Now here we have with the filter of one cuteness level, and that is a fetch request cute one, cute two, cute three, young, old. And basically those are that with the fetch request with template. And of course, I have already created fetch request template with fetch request all, but these are just sorts. So Before we move on, let me just show you how all of those predefined template fetch requests work. So let's just see here. Filter hungry. So there we go. We have all of those. And as you can see, it's, of course, updating automatically. Now, filter one cuteness. Well, we don't have any with the one cuteness filter two. There we go. And as you can see, it's hungry. Well, all of them that are with cuteness level two and cuteness level three, we only have max there. Okay. And finally, filter young, so below age of three. And I don't think we have old here, but yeah, we don't have old. But you just go ahead and create random cats there and you will find those. Okay. And finally, let's just show all. There we go. It's just showing all. Okay. So next up will be this sort by name. Okay. So let me just take a look at the code here. So we are using this fetch request with template, fetch request all. So we are getting all the cats from our core data stack. And then we are applying a sorted on the cats array. And basically what we are doing is grabbing cat 0, cat 1, and we are just grabbing their names and basically just sorting them by name. With this line of code. And of course, we are doing the collection view reload right over here because basically we are not doing the anything to add onto those cats. Like we are not triggering that. So yeah, that's what we are doing here. Sort by name Z to A, and that's just reversing it's called, it's a duck sign, duck. And finally, here we have fetch all. Now we could just use fetch cats, you know, the old type of way of doing this, but we can just call fetch request with template and fetch request all. So let's just take a look at the ordered cuteness, cutest action. So it will be ordered by A to Z and of course by age. So let's just take a look at those functions. Now, this is kind of complicated, but once you get a hang of it, it will be really, really easy. So here we have a compare selector and this is the localized standard compare. Now, what this basically does is that it lets strings to be compared. Now, here we have our source descriptor and our predicate. Now, the source descriptor is basically grabbing the cat's name and setting it, giving us back in ascending order. Now, the predicate, this kind of looks kind of strange to you, but just so you know, here we have our key and here we have our value and here is our key, the cuteness level, and with a comma, here we have our value. And then we create a fetch request as usual, add the sort descriptors, predicate, and then we fetch on the core data stack. Okay, now let's just take a look at the ordered cutest and age. Now, this is just let you know that we can have more than one sort descriptor. That's why it's called sort descriptors. And make sure that you order the sort descriptor as you'd like for it to be used. And basically, that's it. Let's just build and run and see how this looks like. Okay, let's just add some more here. There we go. And filter and sort ordered A to Z. Okay, so that's that. And ordered by age. And of course, the cuteness level should be 3. 4, 3, 1. Okay, really, really nice. Okay, and basically that's it. Make sure that you use this kind of programmatic fetch request. If your fetch request is kind of dynamic, you might want to have this cuteness level as a dynamic one. And you could also cut time on development if you are using the like template fetch request. These are used whenever you know that, okay, you are going to use this a lot of times and it will not change, meaning the properties of our fetch request. And that is all about fetch request. I know it sounded a little bit scary, but now you know that it is not. It is indeed really easy to use fetch request with core data. So now you know how you can sort and filter your core data. How awesome is that? Now, that is it for our core data tutorial series. This is the last episode. If you haven't known already, this is a tutorial series, and go ahead and check out the link in the description for the whole playlist. Now, if you go through each one of these tutorials, then you will ace core data. And why is that important? Well, it is important because that is one of the main persistence stores from Apple. So if you're looking for a job or you just want to broaden your knowledge in the Apple iOS ecosystem, it is imperative that you do learn core data. So go ahead and check out the link below for the whole playlist. Now, I will be posting more videos about iOS stuff. And while you wait for that, go ahead and check out these videos as well too. I talk a lot about Swift, Swift UI, UIKit in general. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.